myself is high. These are my new members. Our topic is one of the main derivatives happened in USA in 2013. So the topic is critical controls that could have prevented the target breach. In the contents of the presentation, we have infographic of this incident in a chronological order we'll explain, and issues regarding the target breach and timeline of the target breach, cost of breach, environmental factors, recommendations, conclusion, and questions at the end. So, Target is the sixth largest retailer in USA at present, but during this attack happened in 2013, they were the fourth largest retailer in USA. So a group of attackers has gained credentials from one of Target's vendors, and they have access to the internal network of Target. Using a malware, they managed to steal credit details of 40 million customers. So moving to the next slide. Here we have the steps that attackers have followed in order to gain access to the target's network. First of all, just like every hackers, they have done a lot of research on the vulnerabilities of the target's network. So once they did this, they have Googled for like weeks about the vulnerabilities of the network, and they finally ended up with Fuzzy Mechanical Services, which is a third party to this target who are providing mechanical services. So they created this email along with a malware embedded email called Citadel Trojan. So with the help of this malware, they have managed to gain the vendor portal access login credentials from this vendor in order to access into Target's internal network. So the portal that they have accessed is called Ariba External Billing System. So once they gained access to this Ariba External Billing System, due to the poor network setup Target had at that time, even their network was not even segmented. So whoever had access to this vendor portal could get access to all the internal network resources. So they finally got access to this Target point of sale system, and they managed to deliver this malware called Blackbus to all the local stores they had. And from there, how they got into the point of sale system is, they had this, the IT governance was so good that they had performance assurance Microsoft server, which they have used in the point of sale system. They haven't even changed the default password. So having the default passwords, they managed to get into this POS system. And they are using this malware called Backpost, which remained silent for 6 days. So they stole like 40 million customer details within these 6 days. After they acquired all the details, the malware started to fetch the collected data, which is 11 GB in size, to the FTP servers in Miami and Brazil, which was later then transferred into Moscow. And on December 2nd, they were warned about this breach by a team of security team in India, because they have 6 months prior to this breach, they have implemented a cybersecurity system called FireEye. This FireEye team has detected some anomaly in their network traffic, and they have warned the target about the breach on 2nd December, but they had not taken any action with regard to this. So in December 12, finally the federal investigation has warned about a massive data breach. And on only 15th December, they've successfully managed to eradicate after losing 40 million of customer details, which data in 2014 February reported that it was 70 million were affected. Credit card details and personal information has been stolen. And later on, the hacker was identified as a Latvian hacker, and he was sentenced to 14 years in prison for receiving this malware. So, moving on to next. Issues regarding target breach, will be explained by
issues regarding, now I'm going to talk about the issues regarding the target breach. So, the first one was the failure to respond to the alerts, because there was no any internal alert on the point of sale system, and the tariff was came to know about that breeze from Department of Justice, and network was not properly segmented network, because vendor portal as well as the main server was both on the same network, and it was possible to hack by the hackers easily the secure information, and application installation was not within control of point of sale system. Vendor portal was not isolated, as I earlier explained that vendor portal was also on the same network as the server. That's why it was easy for the hackers to hack the information, and not reset the default password of the performance insurance Microsoft server. And this is the timeline of the target breach. First one, in September, attackers start their efforts to hack the information. Attackers compromise Prism mechanical service system, and on November 15, attackers broke into target's network and tested the malware. Malware, we all know that malware is a software which is designed to hack the or unauthorized access of any computer. And November 27, attackers begin to collect credit card data. On November 30th, point of sale malware fully installed, and the hackers were successful to install the malware on the point of sale system. And attackers installed data filtration malware, semantic, and FireEye alerts are triggered. On December 2nd, attackers begin to move credit card data out, and additionally FireEye alerts triggered. On December 12th, Department of Justice notified the target, and finally on December it was cleared that there is a breach on point of sale system. Target removed most malware from their system. And now we are going to discuss about the cost of breach. Like banks obligated to refund money stolen from customers via their credit card, and banks had to pay replace cards costing more than $200 million. And US dollars, $202 million. Exactly, it was total $292 million, but the net loss was $202 million according to the target 216 annual financial report. And the other was the loss of CEOs and CIOs job also. And that was the major cost of this week, that CEO has lost his job also. And involvement of actors, there were customers whose data has been hacked, confidential data has been hacked, and the CEO and CIO were also the actors of that breach. Banks were involved. High-ranking target employees means that IT experts and IT managers were also included. High-ranking target employees, vendors, FireEye, Bengaluru, who identified the malware, and Department of Justice and attackers who attacked this breach. Next slide will be discussed by Prachi.
And Bajit explained. So the issue is clear, and the recommendations to follow the basic principles of network segmentations and taking basic security measures like resetting the default passwords of the PCs, and improve monitoring and logging activities, and install applications which are whitelisted to POS systems, and implement POS management tools like limited and disabled vendor vendor access to the main network because that's the main case which was happened because the attackers has came through the vendor's network, which is also in the main network of target, and expand the two-factor authentication and password vaults. And instead of using POS machines, inbuilt magnetic swipe, it's recommended to use a separate POS provided by the bank to authorize the credit cards, and train employees on cybersecurity awareness and properly set up escalation plans in event of a threat, because of the main reason that there's no proper escalation plan for targets, which was happened, which is the main cause was happened in this breach. And for the conclusion, even with the steps that target has taken, regarding the security for the cybersecurity point of view, with the processes that they have taken, the softwares that they have implemented to their systems, they could have prevented the breach by more than 90% if they have act properly with the initial triggers, initial alerts triggered. So that's clear that there's no magical cure to cybersecurity, cyberspace when it comes to protecting a network against cyber threats. It's basically need to take necessary steps that to contain those issues and escalate when it comes a problem. So it's to follow the best practices for cybersecurity and the industry and taking controls by knowing the strengths and weaknesses of the organization can reduce the risk by compromised by a cyber attack. So that's the main conclusion. And with that, management. So that's it. Thank you.